Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome to the first HTML5 tutorial. As I said, this is a tutorial series on web development. So guys, if you missed my first video, please go back and check that. In that I have explained what web development actually is and what we'll be learning in this tutorial series. I'm giving them the link on the upper right, so please click and go back and watch the video and then come back to this. So without wasting time, let's get into the HTML5 part. I'm using Notepad++. I would recommend you to use the same because it is easy and it supports many of the languages. So we'll go and select HTML. So the very first thing we need to do is the two important tags for every web page document. When you are doing HTML, these tags are very much compulsory. So let's start with that. First one is the doc type. As the name says, it is specifying that it is instructing the browser that the document is of HTML type. So this specific line is necessary for pretty much for all the HTML documents. You can, as in the previous video I said, when you go for a web page, right click on the click on view source code, you'll get the first line as doc type HTML. So this is the first line. Then the most important tag is HTML tag. Remember guys, for every opening tag there should be a closing tag. Except some of the exceptions are there. I will be telling you that for this only you can see there is no closing tag for doc type HTML. For HTML it is there. So whatever the web page we are designing, it should be inside HTML tags only. You cannot write, that is the browser do not consider whatever the code you write outside the HTML tags. After the HTML tags, basically the web page is divided into two parts, the head and the body. Let me show you that. So as I said, pretty much the HTML document is divided into two parts, basically the head and the body. So what is this head and body? I will explain you that. It pretty much contains the information you have to information regarding the web page, that is who the author is. Some of the meta tags will be also inside the head tags. I will be saying that later what all the meta tags, and basically the main thing that should be in the head is the information about the web page. So like a title, my very first web page. So let me save this document and show you how it works, what the use of the title bar is. So let me save it. No, I will save it in the desktop as sample.html and I will run it. So you can see the title bar is given as my very first page, very first web page. So this is basically the title tag does. Whatever the information or whatever the page name you're giving, you should give inside the title there. Like many web pages contains multiple documents like home, login page or sign up page or a reset password page. So for the title of the page you're giving that, yeah, and it will be appeared in the browser's title bar. So this is pretty much head. So what comes in the body? Everything that you write over here, what you want to display to the user in this area, it will be under the body section. Like we'll go with the programming terms because hello world is the basically pretty much into every programming language the first program will be hello world. So I'm going to say this, and I'm going to all the time you need not to go and open the document again. You can just click on refresh, so you can see the hello world appears here. So now that you got the difference, whatever the title bar does is it will be, the title for the page is given inside the title bar. And body, whatever the web document or whatever the website you are doing, it should be inside the body only. Whatever the contents you want to display to the user, it should be under body only. So now another important thing is comment. In HTML you use comment with this tag. So comment is basically some important information that you want to give the user. While documentation, it will be very helpful. Like if I have given plenty or 1000 lines of code, so I want to explain each and every part, so it is not possible. So at that time, you can comment. This will be excluded by the browser. It will not be taken into the consideration. So you can see, I will save it and refresh again. Nothing happens. So this is basically the comment. This comment is the extra information that you give to the user. Basically a programmer, extra information regarding your program. So hello world is displayed over here, but this is not the correct programming terms. So for paragraph, if you want to display some information regarding the, if your web page is about some blogging or for that, so you can see or you can use a paragraph tag over there. For P is a paragraph tag. As I said, the opening and close tags is mandatory. Some of the tags are exclusion. While I'm doing the tags, I will tell you this tag need not to be closed, but paragraph tag should be closed. So it works pretty much the same. I will save it and run. So you can see hello world. But why we are giving inside paragraph tag if we can give outside without paragraph tag only? So in some cases, this is very basic program. In some of the cases, we need to do styling for this hello world. So in that case, we'll be considering some of the tags to color the element. Like if I want to change this color, I will save that. You can see the color is changed. So basically tags must these must be paragraph must be embedded within the paragraph tags only. So this is called a styling tag. I will explain you later. This is just for example, I have given that one. So these are the paragraph. Then for every paragraph, there should be some heading. There are 6 levels of heading in the HTML. That is, it start with H1 to H5. Sorry, H6. So as the number increases, the font size will be increased. I will show the difference here. Compared to H1, so I will save this and I will run. So you can see the H1 is pretty big. So this is basically we can give for a title. So this will be title and this is the H1. This will be useful when you are using the when your web page is document related. Like as I said, some blogs or any information, personal information or your resume. So for that, it will be useful, H1 to H6. So as I said, as the level decreases, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6, the font gets smaller. So that's it guys, that's it for this tutorial. In this tutorial, we have learned, we will do a revision from first. This document type just tells what type of document is being written. It is just an instruction to the browser. Actually, the correct way of writing the doc type is not this one. It is pretty much long, the standard way. I will show you that in the next tutorial. And next, the two important tags, HTML. For that, anything you write for the web page, it should be inside the HTML tags only. And then comes the head. Basically, the website is divided into head and body. In the head section, we will be giving the information about the web page, like title, meta tags. I will be explaining in meta tags will be explained in the next tutorial. For first tutorial, let's say it will be a title. Title bar is basically whatever you give inside the title bar, it will be appeared here. Then next comes the headers, H1 to H6, 6 levels of headings, H1, H2, H3, H4, H5 and H6. Basically, as the level decreases, the font level decreases. And next comes the paragraph. Paragraph font is constant. So paragraph font size is constant. In the styling, you can change that. Next, as I said, body and closing the HTML tags. So thank you guys. Please subscribe.